After 6 years in the business, also level 8. So he has something to share with us. Ladies and gentlemen, please bring out Duarte Saldanha. Hello, Prague. Hello, team. Hello, everyone. It's an absolutely massive, massive pleasure to be here talking to you today. I'm going to talk about my story. How did I end up here? My story maybe is unique. For me, it was what I'm doing today was absolutely unthinkable a few years ago, and you'll soon learn why. So, my name is Duarte Saldanha. I'm from that beautiful country named Portugal. I am 36 years old. 36 years old. I'm married, and I have 3 beautiful children. So, you can see that right from an early age, I wanted to get the difficult part out of the way first. So I did not want to enjoy my retirement years later on. I wanted to get married soon. I want to have children soon. I want to make money soon so then I can enjoy my life whilst I'm still young. So that's exactly what I did, but I didn't know how I was going to do it. So, quick summary. For those who do not know, there is Portugal on the western coast of Europe. When I was... I live there normally, amazing family. My parents are still up there. I was with my sister living normally in Estoril. And when I was 10, my parents called me up to the living room and said, Duarte, Maria, I've got something to tell you. We are moving to Kenya. Now, I'm 10 years old. There's no Google. Okay, so what is Kenya? Opened up the first book I got hold of, and I saw a picture of a lake with flamingos. So I'm like, great, I'm going there, I'm 10, I don't care. So I went. I was there for 5 years. When I was 15, I went to boarding school in the UK, and then university in the UK as well, where I studied economics. So very shortly, this was exactly what I did until I was 21. And then what happened? I was taught from a very young age, like most of us were probably, that we have to work doing 40 hours a week for 40 years to receive 40% of your income as retirement. Just to test the IQ level of the room, does anybody believe this? 15,000 intelligent people, great. So, I believe it. So I went for a normal job. I started going the rat race, running around. Now, I was doing that. My first job was with a very big corporation, the biggest in the world, Nestle. I was there for about a year, and I absolutely hated it. My monthly salary after my parents spending hundreds of thousands of euros on my education was 750 euros a month. So yesterday, just for the foundation, it was more than my yearly salary a few years ago. I decided something had to change. I was very disappointed. I went to another company. Maybe things are different there. But they weren't. They're exactly the same. And then I realized maybe it's not something to do with the company. Now I realized it was to do with my mindset. And you know this Facebook memories? It's interesting because it gives you a review of what your life was a few years ago, what my mindset was. So these are a few print screens of what my ambition was. I was waiting for the PlayStation game. That was where my head was. And then what happened? A month later, I'm broke. I need money. This was my mindset, going on Facebook and talking about this. Am I crazy? But at the time, it sounded right. I bet all of you, including me, have friends that all they do is complain on Facebook. That's all they do. And then it really started to get better. So I thought things are going to have to change. So I thought, no, maybe I can go into my boss's office and ask him for a raise. That sounds good. Been a company for a few years. I was brand manager for a company that has a product that was turning over millions of euros every single year, earning 1,000 euros a month then, already married. Things have changed. And my boss's office said, João, give me a raise. His first reaction, he laughed at me. Then I'm like, no, I'm serious. Give me a raise or I'm out. And he's like, okay, I'm going to give you 5% raise. And for 2 seconds, I thought, yes, I got it. And then I started doing the math. 5% of 1,000 euros is 50 euros. What can I do with 50 euros today? Easy shop, excellent. But that's it. Can't even take my wife out for dinner. So I decided, enough's enough. I'm out, thank you for the opportunity. I'm now going to be an entrepreneur. In my head, being an entrepreneur was amazing. Lifestyle, boats, travels, everything. In reality, I had to be the best at everything. I had to deal with the marketing, with the sales, with the distribution, with the human resources, with all these things, dealing with partners I did not want to deal with, investing all this money. And I thought, the reason why I'm doing this, the reason why I'm working like I am, is because right now is the life that I have. That's what I wanted. This is my beautiful wife, my 3 beautiful children, just a few months ago. And I thought, going exactly that same way, thank you. If I went exactly the same way as I have gone in the past 7 years, I would have been exactly the same. So I thought, there has to be a better way. I cannot keep on doing this, dealing with all these problems I don't want, counting money at the end of every month. So I thought, what's in the market? I've tried being an employee, didn't suit me. Not very good at it either, to be honest. Trying to be a regular entrepreneur, also not very good at it. Then I thought, maybe I'll try franchise. That makes sense. They give you a business plan, they give you a brand, they promote that brand, they give you everything. All you have to do, just follow the plan, and eventually you make money, right? That's the plan. What is the problem? Two. One, to build a big franchise, I needed 1 million euros. Didn't have it. To build a small franchise, not my thing. Either go big or do nothing. So, one uncle of mine called me up. An uncle of mine who was an entrepreneur, who had the life that I dreamt. He had the boat, he had the Porsche, he had the house, he had everything. Beautiful family, also 3 children. So I thought, hang on, if he's calling me about this business, I have to go. I had heard about network marketing before, but it didn't appeal to me. You buy a product, you grow your hair, I wish. You become healthy, you grow taller, and then you sell that product and become even richer. I didn't buy that. But I thought, if my uncle is with Lyconet, maybe something's different. And I went to listen to him. And for the first day, I was in. I just didn't understand too much, but I understood 2 things. We're building a shopping community. That means consumers, it means companies. And in my head, if it made sense for these 2 entities, then it made sense for me not to save in a few years, but to build the business now. And for the consumer, it's free, and they save money. And for the consumer, we help them develop their business. So I said, I'm in. What was the problem? I didn't have 2,400 euros. I had to find it. And that scared the living hell out of me. I was 30 years old at the time, and I did not have 2,400 euros. I had 2 children already, the 3rd one coming. But it took me 10 days to find it. But I found it. But What's the number one skill in business? I know what the skills are, the contact list, the invitation, the presentation, so on. But before you can do any of that, you have to be able to talk. That's the main thing, to communicate, to get your message across. There was a problem with me, though. Since I was born, I was a stutterer. I don't know if that translates well. I was gagu. I couldn't speak. Every few words was ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. So imagine me now. I love this business, but I can't talk. How the hell am I going to do this business? And that's a true story. You know those plays in school, which children have to do? I was always the tree in the back. As a product manager, I didn't make the presentation for my sales team. I asked my assistant to do it. I simply did not talk to more than one or two people at a time. Simply not possible. And then I started to develop my mindset a bit. I remember talking to my therapist, and I asked her, listen, is there some operation I can do and make it go away? She's like, no. So it's so psychological then. Yeah? Interesting. So what am I doing here then? So I had two choices. I could go with my excuses. It's impossible. I can't speak. Also, other excuses. I'm broke. I don't have time. I have my own company and three children. My company has three employees. I had all the excuses in the world. But in life, two ways, excuses or results. And I managed to turn my excuse into an advantage. So, stutter, fact. First option, not possible for me. I will never be able to speak on stage, never. Let alone five people, 15,000, forget that. So, what is not possible? B, turn it into my advantage. How do you say? Well, if they don't understand the first time, they'll surely understand the repetitions. Thank you. I have two moments within Lyconet, two periods. The first period was I joined till 2013. I was full of excuses. I didn't present. My first 100 contacts were 100 no's. Things were not easy. And in 2013, I was level 2. Okay, I was very proud of level 2. And Mario Regia came to Portugal for a big event at the time, 200 people. And he went out on stage and he did what Mario does. He got everybody excited, everyone, yes, we're gonna go level 8. Everybody excited. Then he said, this was a Tuesday, and the whole of country had one level 2. And he said, next Saturday, gonna bring 200 people again here. And I want you all to bring your contacts and it's gonna be great. So I'm like, yeah, I'll do it, it's gonna be great. And then he left. On Friday, I got called up to a conference call with Mike Muller and Mario Regia. I was talking to them, and Mario said, Duarte, are you ready? For what? For the presentation. I'm like, yeah, I've got five guests, I'm absolutely ready. No, you're speaking. Sorry, Mario, you must be confusing me with somebody else. I don't speak, that's not my thing. Somebody else has to do it. But he said, okay, you have two options. You don't speak, that's fine, accept it. But if you want to take this market, step up the plate. Take the market, do it, face your fears. So I did it. It was the worst presentation anybody has ever done with Lyconet. Took about 3 hours, even though I had only 5 slides. I sweated like nobody's ever sweated before. I was shaking like some crazy guy, but I did it. Next week, we didn't have to, thank you. Next week, we didn't have 200 guys. We had only 7, and 6 of them were already marketers. Nobody wanted to hear me, but I kept on going and kept on going, kept on going. And I got a wild card to go to the leaders convention in Prague. And that was in Vienna, in Palmhagen. And that was a big life changer for me, because I came there as level 2. I was very proud, but I was cocky and arrogant. And I was there talking, hi Mario, hi Mike, hi Hubert, hi Mario Capun, hi Marco Zadovnik, hi everybody, I'm number 1 of Portugal. Very proud, drinking them, thinking I'm, you know, the best. That was a Sunday night. On Monday, it was starting. New production month. I opened my computer. level one. I had lost my career level at the career convention, at the leaders' convention. Imagine how I felt. This small. I felt like the biggest loser in the world. I had this opportunity in my hand, and I'm wasting it, thinking I'm good just because I have a few meetings. And from that moment on, I took more notes in 4 days of the convention than I did during my whole 3 years of university. I started to focus. I decided no more be an amateur. No more. I want to become a professional in this business. I started studying it. I started discovering what I was doing wrong and what I can do right. And then, of course, everything changed. From 2013, a few months later, I was level four, and then the rest is history. This company has taken me to incredible places, all over the world, all continents. I met some amazing people. I learned these amazing cultures from all over the world, all because of this company and all the work we are doing together. But why didn't I quit? There were so many reasons I should have quit. I had 3 children in 2013. I was still not making money. I had all the reasons. I was always scared. What if Hubert was right? What if? And I quit because it was difficult. I quit because my friends told me no. Because my broke friends told me no. I was scared. And I saw this phrase recently, which I loved. Do something today that your future self will thank you for. I want to go back to 2013 and 14 when I worked like an animal. I want to hug that guy. Because of that reason, I'm here right now. Because whatever happens, in 4 years' time, you're going to be 4 years older. That's it. What are you going to do with that period of time? My first sensation was in 2014. I went on stage as level four. And for the whole year, 2013, there were a few level fours, not many level fives, very few level sixes, and one level seven, Martin Mander from Estonia. All from 1 year. Now, you saw what happened yesterday. The rhythm, the speed, and what this company is going through right now. Imagine this same event in a few years' time. Where are you going to be? How big is going to be your sector? So we were 30 there. Then we went to Sensation in Las Vegas, a leaders' convention, when I had my small group of team leaders with me. Then we went to Firstly seminar in Vienna. Absolutely amazing. We're already a small group, already starting to create some movement within the team. Secondly seminar, also in Vienna. Third, first time I went on stage, has level seven. Now a mate, and that's my good president friend, Andrea Azevedo, level seven. Very soon, level eight. We signed to grow, September. Already a very nice team. The sixth was here a year ago. You remember? Absolutely incredible. Then a few months ago, in Torino, Italy, amazing event again. First time has a level eight. And now here we are again. Can I see, can I hear what my team is doing right now? Thank you, thank you. Obrigado. You cannot buy something like this. You have to create your team spirit. You have to create leaders. You have to be a leader. Because all the potential of this company is in front of us. Our goal is 1 billion active consumers. We're not even 1% of the way there yet. 99 is for us to take. And this opportunity we're sitting in right now with this in our hands. I don't believe we have to be that much of a visionary right now to take part in this business and work like we've never worked before. I believe the visionaries, people who started years ago, even before the cashback card was actually launched in 2008, those were the visionaries. Everything's ready for us. All we have to do is full gas, all in. Times are moving so fast. A few years ago, it took us decades to get to a new technology. Then it took us a few years, then a few months. Right now, we launched our iTime app a couple days ago and already tens of thousands of new downloads. We have to move fast if we want to get ahead. If we stand still, we simply go backwards. And we are fortunate enough to have the biggest visionary in the world leading the way and showing how we should do it. Eric talked about this today. Plan, do, review. Plan, do, review. That's all we do as well. Make the plan. Do the plan. Then see what went wrong. If it's good, improve it. If it's bad, delete it. Next, 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 next. Guaranteed will be much better the next time. We talked about this so much as well. Make a decision. Without decision, none of this works. With a strong decision made, a strong why behind, believe me, it will not matter if you miss your football game, if you miss a wedding, if you miss some weird TV program. It will not matter because your decision's made. That means you'll do it regardless of what happens. And there are so many people with excuses, it drives me insane. I can't come because my cat has his birthday. I heard that before. Are you crazy? Talk about marketers. So we have this amazing opportunity. In a few months, we'll have another massive event. The decision is that each and every one of us has to make is, how much is my market share going to be at that event? Simple as that. We're talking about the global market that costs, if you go shopping, €0 to build. All you have to do is build a business and then go shopping. That's it. So simple, it hurts. How many friends of ours who told us no are trying to bring us down? And you know why they told us no? Because if we, why they're angry, I mean. Because if we succeed and they told us no, they're the idiots. So they're trying to bring you down. Don't accept that. People say that I dream too big. No. They dream too small. We are just getting started. If you want, today is the first day of the rest of your life. If you apply everything you learned, you make a decision and go. Like my good friend says, all in or go home. Thank you so much.
Duarte Saldanha!